Hit me. It's gonna hurt. Hit me there.
I'm Elizabeth Debicki, and I am playing Princess Diana on The Crown.
I'm Dominic West, and I'm playing Prince Charles on The Crown. And I'm available for bar mitzvahs and other things as well. I'll play Prince Charles anywhere you like.
I'm Alison Harvey. I'm the set decorator on The Crown. OK, so our job is to try and create the world that the actors can sort of inhabit. We try and make that whole environment feel believable, I suppose. Start with a colour and an architecture, which is sort of more to do with Martin as a designer. And then we build up the furniture and the layers. So it's you start with the flooring, the lighting, the big sort of lumps of furniture, then you just layer and layer and layer until you get to the paintings, and ultimately you end up with the paper knife. It's like moving house every day. And hopefully by the end of it, it looks like someone lives there.
Yeah, it's extraordinary. I mean, I always think it's amazing how, down to the fact that if you're dealing with paperwork or in a meeting about something, the stuff that's printed on things, which no one will ever see, and most actors probably wouldn't even read it. That's the level of detail that the props department go to, and so much goes unseen and unthanked.
Thanks.
Say goodnight to Mr. Major.
Goodnight.
Goodnight.
It's so funny, when I look at this prop, I can hear Ted, who plays Prince Harry in the first two episodes, I can hear little Ted's voice going, beep, 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 and doing the Pingu song.
Really?
That's how much it was, but you weren't there.
No, thank God. I mean, no, I missed it.
They're your children.
Special treat, you get to choose between a bedtime story or...
Super Mario!
Game Boy was Williams. Again, very kind of iconic of that era. And allegedly, this is what Diana liked.
Mm-hmm. What's that called?
Bluegrass.
But smell it. It's so amazing. All these things, I was obsessed with them because... It's
they are
really
resonant, aren't they?
Like the 90s.
Can you get it spray?
Don't know.
It
fills the room.
Strong. Yeah. Do you remember the first time I came here? And I was like, I put it all over myself. And then I was like, whoa.
Yeah, it lingers.
The other thing was the watercolours here. I remember when I first arrived and they said, this is your watercolour set. And this actually is Josh O'Connor's own watercolour sketchbook. He learned to do watercolours and used to do them to get him into the character. And I thought, oh, I haven't a chance in this part. Because I've never touched those watercolours that day to this.
The other day I was doing a scene and there was this amazing tub of, I thought it was hand cream, and I saw it in the kitchen set, and I was, because this is what your department do amazingly well, there's just the detail of everything, every drawer you open, every shelf. Remember the first time we went into the kitchen and we were like, ooh, and we kept looking at all the amazing...
Probably the fake cupboards you can't open, apart from that.
Yeah, apart from that. But I found this tub of hand cream, and I was like, oh, God, it just looked so 90s and perfect. So I took it to the next set, and so during the scene, I, like, dug in, and it was this sort of gel green stuff. I put it all over my hands. I was like, So... And I was doing, really watching the TV and putting his hand cream on. I did so many takes, and after a while, I started to feel quite ill. It was so strong, and then I looked and realised it was just hair gel.
Well, I was inside the courtyard earlier on, and I was talking to one of the Queen's aides, and I asked...
One of the worst things that happened this season was three of the prop trucks with our kind of antiques got broken into overnight, and all the antiques were stolen off the back of the trucks, which obviously was a bit of a nightmare because we had to try and replace them quickly. But the funny thing was that it was reported, there was a truck stop on the M1. The truck drivers called the police and said, we've had a break-in, can you come and investigate? And they went, no, we can't, got no time for that. We've got a body, we've got a murder investigation to sort out. And it turned out that there was a naked woman floating upside down in the canal, but it was one of our prosthetics.
Did you say? That's one of ours.
That's one of ours. Give it back. We're trying to get it back, actually.
Really?
The police have still got it, yeah.
And what's happened to the Fabergé eggs on the ground?
They're probably in a landfill somewhere by now, I think.
But it's definitely an inside job. Were you involved?
No.
Did you get a cut?
No.
Yeah, you did.
Not the waiting that made me miserable. It was the years spent rotting in a marriage to someone trying to destroy me.
So we got these. You were having a fight in the kitchen, do you remember?
Yeah.
Oh.
But we never used them.
In the script, it was written that we have an argument, and then when you left the room, that I was to fling the plate at the door, which would have honestly been a frisbee moment from heaven if I'd managed to have been like...
Break it over Alison's head.
Yeah, go on.
It's plastic.
No, it should break.
Go on,
try.
No.
I'm not going to break it over someone's head.
Break it over Alison's head.
Dominic!
All right, break it over my head. Hit the forehead there.
It might not. It might. Maybe just try it on the table.
No, do it on my head. Go on. Quick, go on. Watch this.
On which bit? That bit?
All of it.
I'm not sure. Dominic,
hit me.
It's gonna hurt.
Hit me there. Come on.
Oh. Ow! That really hurts. What the f*** are you doing? Get off.
Well, I hope that was interesting insight into the world of props and breakaways and the detail that we try and bring to the Crown.